I think the most remarkable thing about the scaling of biological systems or organisms in general is the fact that they do scale, meaning that if you look across a large spectrum of sizes of organisms, say if you look at all mammals, from the smallest mammal, which in English is called the shrew, which is about this big, to the blue whale, which is bigger than the room that we're in now. The whale weighs about 100 million times more than the shrew, and they look quite different. And in between all those mammals sit giraffes and horses and human beings and cats and dogs and so on. And we believe that all of these organisms and their unique characteristics evolved by natural selection, by Darwinian evolutionary process, that you would have expected, or rather, you would not have expected any relationship between them, because each one evolved with its own unique history and in its own unique environment. Not only each organism, but each subsystem of the organism, each organ, each cell type, each genome, all has its own unique history. So you would think that if you looked at how some physiological variable scaled with size, how it changes as you go from, say, the shrew to the whale, you would expect that there would just be some random kind of structure that is representative of each of the unique histories of those organisms. And the amazing thing is that it's quite the contrary. If you looked across all types of organisms, fish, birds, insects, cells even, as well as mammals, you saw the same kind of regular behavior. So this strongly suggests that there were some physical principles at work that were constraining the way each of these organisms evolved. And that's what got me excited about thinking about biological systems and trying to find what is the key to this hidden structure.